Just imagine. The floor is a graph. A graph of life. A diagonal, for example. A marriage as a diagonal. Divorce. The screw. Spring. You mention a woman. First you say you met her on the train. Another time you say you met her in a restaurant. Actually, you met her at our apartment. On the couch. If you make a parabola, it's a reconciliation. May I tell you something about myself? I graduated from college and had a job for 6 months. I've been married 3 times and have 3 children. I thought that way I'd have company for the rest of my life, but I was wrong. I always tried to put my best foot forward. My conduct is exemplary. I help the hostess. I bring the guests home. I have the skill for appropriate comments. I avoid mentioning divorces. I inquire about your health. I mean well. I'm not heartless. I'm idealistic. I'm sincere and truthful. I work in favor of peace. I contribute to the support of an Asian child. My conduct is never eccentric. I dress in good taste. I have a flair for fashion. I don't look bad, do I? I go to the hairdressers. I brush my teeth. I check myself in the mirror every day.
And what do you see?
Nothing. I mean, nothing special. Something like that. Just the usual.
And what does that mean?
I don't know. is a deeply pessimistic person. A Capricorn, perhaps. No. I think he's a Scorpio. Aggressive and pushy, especially around Christmas. The way I see it, you're searching for the meaning of existence.
Yes.
What you're looking for is a neurotic dependency relationship.
Your interpersonal relationships are flawed. You're inhibited socially.
Oh. You know, your oral fixation is caused by a lack of affection.
You are obsessed. My verbal violence.
You're using your anxiety to pressure me.
Yeah, and what you don't know is that you are a slave of your own inferiority complex.
You're neglecting your castration anxiety.
And you abuse your psychological insight.
You're in a continuous state of acute depression.
You're avoiding the confrontation with your fantasy.
Someday, your narcissistic impulses are going to lead to an implosion.
And your dialectical sensibility is absolutely minimal. Sometimes I suffer from and sometimes from I'm ill at ease with ants. Yesterday, I was in the beauty salon. I misunderstood the telephone message and ran out screaming. Everyone turned around and looked at me I was so ashamed. I thought I would die. How can I ever face them again? But it could have been something terrible. Something terrible could...
My third husband has taken to calling me up evenings. It's me, he says. We've just been to a nice Mexican restaurant and to a storefront theater piece, celebrating the hopelessness of everything. Don't you see what you're missing, Pequeña? If only he would call earlier, when the children are still awake.
I know three people who have committed suicide. Quite a few, I think. One drowned himself, one shot himself, and one took an overdose. And the fourth? They didn't know each other. Now, I examine my face every morning. That's nobody's business. I've become very introspective and think about continuity. Imagine you want to commit suicide. Thank you. And you know, don't know anyone to whom you can address your parting note.